Hallelujah, hallelujah. The Lord came through. He's never let you down. He's never left you. He will never forsake you. God has always been there. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever, He will always be there for you. And church, that's what I was saying a while ago, name one time that God's ever failed you. He's never failed you. He's always been able to see ahead. And this thing, ye are bought with a price. If you belong to Jesus today, now listen, that means heart knowledge. If you have Christ dwelling in your heart, you belong to Him, because it says, ye are bought with a price. Christ paid the price on Calvary for you. He shed His blood for you. Therefore, glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's. Now, I want you to understand that you belong to God. His Son bought you, and you belong to God Jehovah. You're no longer of your own. You no longer are your own, but you belong to God. And I want to explain, and the Lord here again, I know that some of you may in here say, well, Lord, are we going there again? Well, yes, we are. We're going there again. Why? Because there's thousands and thousands and thousands and tens of thousands joining by television that don't know. And God has told me in this Latter-day Harvest to warn them and to teach them, because there's many denominations that have their children or their congregations in bondage. And God doesn't want you to be in bondage. He wants you to be set free. And He's told me, He said, tell them the truth that I bought them. Now, I'm talking about the ones that have heart knowledge of God. If you've got mind knowledge of God, you belong to the devil. If you've got Christ up here, you belong to the devil. And you've still yet, and John 3:17 will tell you that, because you have to believe in your heart. Romans 10:9-10, for if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in thine heart that God hath raised Him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. You have to have heart knowledge. But if you will, turn with me to John 10:27. The gospel according to John 10:27, because this is going to be a teaching as well as a preaching this morning. In 10:27, Jesus says, my sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. And I give unto them eternal life, that they shall never perish, neither shall any man pluck them out of my hand. My Father which gave them me is greater than all, and no man is able to pluck them out of my Father's hand. I and my Father are one. Now, I hear preacher after preacher quoting John 3:16, and they say, well, it says should there. Well, that's fine. It does say should. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him should not perish, but have everlasting life. But here, Christ makes it pretty plain. He said, and verse 28, I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish. Now, for those of you joining by television that may not know the definition of never, this is the Strong's Concordance, which is the Greek and the Hebrew. And this is where I go many, many times seeking and searching Scripture. And the word never in John 10:28, the Greek word is oume. O-O-M-A-Y, oume, and it means, it's a double negative, it's strengthening the denial, not at all is the original Greek Greek word, not at all, the definition, anymore, not at all anymore, nor by any means, nor by no means, neither, never at all, neither, never, in no case, in no wise, not ever, and at any time. Now, a lot of people say, well, I don't know about that Strong's Concordance, but that's the original Greek definition. Here is the Random House Dictionary, and the definition in here for never is not ever. It's got five basic meanings for never. Not ever, at no time, neither at all, absolutely not, to no extent or degree. Now, Jesus says, he that believeth in me shall never perish, which means never ever, not ever, at no time, not at all, absolutely not, to no extent or degree shall one ever perish if they believe in him. This is Random House Dictionary. And then I've got one that goes back to 1958. I said, well, maybe somebody changed the definition here recently. These are the books that I study out of, by the way, when I want to know what it says. This one here goes back to 1958, Funk and Wagnall Dictionary. And it says the definition here, not at, for never, N-E-V-E-R, not at any time, never ending, not at all, positively not, at no time. So when Jesus says, he that believeth in me shall never perish, that means you never will perish. Now God, Jesus tells us in Revelation 1:18, he says, I hold the keys to death. And I hold the keys to hell and the grave. He holds all the keys this morning. And we can go on and on through Scripture, but Jesus holds the keys to death. And he made me a promise. He said, when I come into you, David, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. I'll be with you even until the end. And that's a promise. He said, ye shall never perish. He that believeth in me and him that sent me is not, shall not come into condemnation, but is passed from death unto life. John 5:24, is past, not shall come to pass, not will be past, but I've come to tell you today that man wants you to follow man's doctrine. Man wants you to believe that you have to live a life good enough to get into heaven, but I've come to tell you today that, praise God, as long as you know the Lord Jesus Christ in your heart, as long as God dwells inside of you, and as long as the blood has been applied to your heart, that's all you need to cross over Jordan. That's all you need to get into the streets of glory and avoid the pits of hell. As long as you have Christ in your heart, and as long as your sins are under the blood, and as long as you have the Comforter dwelling inside of you, that Comforter is the Holy Ghost, and that Comforter is there to teach you all things. And I've come to tell you today, you place your trust in the Lord Jesus. As Christ went up on the cross that day, he said to the Father, he said, Father, it is finished. I've done my part. I've done all that needs to be done to deliver the people. All they have to do now is believe. And faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And praise God, all we're to do is to preach the truth. He said, if I be exalted, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men. And you've got to be drawn by the Holy Spirit. And those of you in churches that talk about you stumble today and you lose your salvation, you spit the wrong way and you lose your salvation, you can take your salvation off. I've come to tell you right now that my salvation is not in my clothes. It's not in my coat. Hallelujah. I can take that coat off, and I'm still just as saved as I've ever been. And it's not in my clothes. It's not in my walk. It's not in my word. It's not in my necktie. I can take my tie off, and praise God, I'm still just as saved as I'm ever going to be. Why? Because my salvation rests in the cross. It doesn't rest in me. It doesn't rest in man. It doesn't rest in my works. It rests, hallelujah, in what I believe. And I believe in Jesus Christ, and Jesus is the one. He's the only one that's going to see me through. Man may fall, and man may kick me down, and man may put me down. But let me tell you something, my salvation rests in the blood of Jesus this morning. It's not in my shoes. It's not in my pants. It's not in my clothes. It's not in my conversation. It's not in my mentality. It's not in my education. It's in the blood of the Lamb. It's the cross. It's the cross. It's the price that was paid at this cross. Praise God, it was the price that Christ paid on Calvary. That's the blood, and that's the price that got my name written in the Lamb's Book of Life. It's not by anything that man can say. It's not by anything that man can do. And we've been called a Jesus fanatics. We've been called everything that you can call us. But let me tell you this. Praise God, can a man love God too much? Can a man love Jesus Christ too much? If you'd have been on my road to hell, if you'd have been walking with me that day when Christ knocked on my heart's door, you would know why. You would know why I'm like I am today, because I know that I know that I know that there was a change in my life. I may not be perfect, but I'm forgiven. Hallelujah, I've been forgiven. And it's all by the blood. It's all by the blood. Jesus, listen, you preachers, listen.